Heavenly Father, we thank you for Russell and Kaylee and their decision to become one in your sight today. We have come together to watch the miracle of your love and the power of your Holy Spirit working in their lives. Father God, who saw that it was not good for man to live alone, and who established marriage for the happiness and well-being of men and women, we thank you for your gift of love to these two. And we rejoice on this glad occasion as Russell and Kaylee come together on the altar to be joined in this sacred ceremony and to make meaningful promises to each other. We thank you in Jesus' name. Amen.
Well, babe, here we are. We finally made it. Today marks the first day of the rest of our lives. We will start an adventure that is going to last a lifetime. A journey that is only bound by our imaginations. We're going to do some amazing things in life, and I couldn't imagine sharing them with anyone other than you. Today, I get to marry my best friend. Kaylee, you are the sweetest, most loving, compassionate, and sensitive person I've ever known. Your smile is bright enough to light up the darkest room. Your voice is soft like an angel's whisper that calms the soul. Oh, let's not forget those eyes. Oh my goodness, those eyes. They're as beautiful as the stars on a clear country night. I get lost every time I look into them. All that aside, your heart is what I treasure the most. You have loved me and supported me even when I didn't deserve it. You've taught me the true meaning of passion, and a lifetime is not enough to repay you for all that you've done for me, but I'm going to work at it each and every day. Kaylee, I promise to love you and to hold you, to support you and encourage you. I promise to lift you up and help you grow. I promise to frustrate you and challenge you. I also promise to laugh and cry with you. And, you know, maybe sometimes I might even let you win an argument. I promise to give you 110% every day and to remind you how much I love you. I'm excited for what life has in store for us. I'm excited to watch our love grow stronger each day. I'm excited to start a family and be the examples our children look up to. I'm excited to grow old with you. When we look back on this day, we must always remember how far we have come. I'm grateful that God has blessed me with you as my partner. You're the piece of my life that I've been missing. Today, with everyone here as my witness, I freely submit to you as to be your husband. I love you, Kaylee Ray, with all my heart and soul.
Here, surrounded by the people that mean the most to us, and I know that the Lord and our loved ones in heaven are smiling down on us. I am so blessed and excited to be able to spend every day with you by my side, laughing with you, being total dorks together in the privacy of our home and out in public for everyone to see. It doesn't matter what we are doing, my heart is whole when we are together. You are my fairy tale. Your heart is huge, and anyone who's met you will agree. You are a model example of the Lord's command to love your neighbor. I've never heard you say no to helping anyone. I could go on and on, so I will. You are hardworking and a jack of all trades. You love your family, and you'll be such a good daddy someday. You make me laugh like no one else can, and you're truly my best friend. You are a great man. I hope that in our life we will be able to touch the lives of others by spreading the love and joy that I feel with you every day. Russell,
together.
I vow to try every day to be the best wife and person that I can be. I vow to stand by you in times of hardship and lift you up when you are down. I vow to always fight for our love, our faith, and our friendship. As you know, I change my mind a lot, but I've never been so sure about anything. I love you.
Your vows have stated that you submit to one another in the responsibilities of this life, expecting God and His power to always make the difference. Ecclesiastes 4:12 says, "Though one may be overpowered, two can defend themselves. A cord of three strands is not quickly broken." This passage from Ecclesiastes illustrates the importance of Christian companionship. Two Christians that are bound together in Christ are stronger than the individuals themselves. We believe that Christian marriage is about more than the union of one man and one woman. The Bible teaches us that God performs a miracle today in your marriage, uniting you together in a covenant relationship with Him as one. As a representative now of Jesus Christ before Almighty God and by the power of the Holy Spirit of God, I now pronounce you one together. You are now husband and wife. Russell, you may kiss the bride. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. and Mrs. Russell Haley.
I'm Renee, the maid of honor, a best friend, a big sister when I can. I met Kaylee back when we worked at camp for Campfire in 2013, and ever since then we've been doing all the shenanigans, getting stuck on water towers and pushing each other around in carts. Camp stuff, camp stuff. I want you two to go out there and make the best adventure that you can, and you know, call me up and we can all go through the adventure somewhere. So I'm so happy for you and welcome to the family, little brother. Here. So, cheers to my baby sister and little brother.
I think we're about 3 or 4 years old. We've been through a lot together. Some good times, some rough times, but in the end, I think we're pretty solid. So to see him find someone that he loves and he loves to spend his, the rest of his life with, that it's very important to me, and I'm, I know he's happy. Kaylee, Russell loves you. The fact that he makes, or that you make him so happy, means everything to me. And I wish you two the best. So, for Russell and Kaylee.
Straighten down, little bit. Straighten down, little bit.
Yeah!